This is what's going on. I'm getting tested today for coronavirus. I don't know if my ex-wife has it, but I'm worried, I guess, you know. But what I'm really worried about is that I never knew my wife had HIV, and it's kind of cold. We've been married all those years. She comes out to Minnesota, gets sick, and finds out that she has HIV. So then find out after we had a long talk, after she was out of the hospital and stuff, that she's originally from Minnesota. And she had a baby. She got rid of the baby to get rid of her ex. So we've been arguing a lot and stuff because she never told me she had HIV stage 3. And asked for a divorce in November. And back to the same thing. She always tried to kill herself and stuff. You know, find out that she was put away in the hospital by her mom. She's Korean. Her name is Margaret Mee Kniff, and her marriage name is Margaret Mee Melillo. She goes by so many different names. Margaret Kniff, Mimi Melillo, Kniff Melillo. She goes by so many different names, and her lies are just not there no more. You know, I just don't believe nothing that ever comes out of her mouth. So on January 5th, about 11:30 at night, she tried to kill me. And she says she wants to give me AIDS like she has it and stuff. And I had to wait till the next day because she took the car keys and everything. And I didn't know where the car keys was on the 6th until she got home. Then I got the car keys and I went straight to the hospital and stuff. Still waiting for the results, you know. So then on May 7th, I come home from washing the car and she's chatting, video chatting with somebody on the phone, showing her body. Called Skyping, you know, and so now I gotta move and all of this stuff, and she's no good. So y'all fellas watch out for Margaret Melillo, or Margaret Mee Kniff. She's Asian, well, she's Korean, and she's from Minnesota, and she lies so damn good, dude. She lies so damn good. She changed the checking account, took all the money out. She took the stimulus check. She took my disability money. She took everything, everything, everything. Now I got to fight a restraining order, and I got to fight a case that she claimed that I assaulted her, never touched her. She hit me, you know, and these women just get away with this stuff. If I was a guy that had AIDS and I did what she did to me, I'd be in jail looking at life, and she's supposed to be in jail.